Everybody has a personality. But what happens when we say somebody has a personality disorder? What we're saying there is that there's a really marked deviation from what we expect and how we expect them to behave or how they are experiencing the world. And that really leads to a great deal of distress and impairment in their functions. One of the things that we know in the current categorization is that there are 10 personality disorders and they are separated into 3 clusters. Cluster A, Cluster B, and Cluster C. As a general overview, the personality disorder in Cluster A are often defined as being odd or eccentric. Those in B are often labeled as dramatic, emotional, or erratic. And finally, in Cluster C, these personality disorders are often described as encompassing anxiety and fearfulness features. There's a fair degree of overlap between these clusters, and it may vary well that even though there are 10 different types of personality disorder, an individual may have one or more types. So let's start with A. In our A category, we have 3 different personality disorders: paranoid personality disorder, schizoid personality disorder, and schizotypal personality disorder. So let's start off with paranoid personality disorder. The key feature that really causes impairment here is that the profound distrust and suspicion of other people. Let's look at the schizoid. Someone with schizoid is often emotionally detached in their relationships, and shows little emotion. And finally, the schizotypal. People with schizotypal personality disorder not only tend to avoid close relationships, but they also have this kind of odd or magical thinking that would really differentiate them from the other Cluster A personality disorders. So as we can see, these individuals are somewhat odd and detached from the people that are around them, and they may have unusual beliefs or degrees of distrust or suspiciousness.
Let's move on to Cluster B. This is a cluster that has 4 of the personality disorders, including antisocial, borderline, histrionic, and narcissistic. As mentioned earlier, Cluster B often contains dramatic, emotional, or erratic traits. When we think about people with antisocial personality disorder, they tend to have little or no regard for others. They're often involved in the legal system, they may commit crimes, and they will often show no remorse. They're very inconsiderate of others. Secondly, we have borderline. People on the borderline are always at the brink of having some kind of emotional or relationship issue. They have very unstable relationships. Their emotions can be really unstable too, and they could have a really variable self-image. They can be pretty impulsive, and this can put them in a lot of danger. Next, we have histrionic. People with histrionic personality disorder are very attention-seeking. They might wear very bright clothes, they might wear things that are very provocative, and they can display a lot of their emotions outwardly. Finally, in this category, we have narcissistic. People with narcissistic personality disorder have huge egos. They might think that they're the best thing since sliced bread. They have a lot of need for admiration and praise, and they don't take it lightly if you criticize them. One of the other ways to describe them is being very grandiose. They think very highly of themselves, much more highly than you would think of them. And finally, let's move on to our last cluster, the anxious and fearful Cluster C. In this cluster, we have three different personality disorders. We have avoidant, dependent, and obsessive compulsive personality disorder. Let's start with avoidant. The main issue with people who are avoidant is that they're very inhibited. They feel inadequate. And generally, they try to avoid putting themselves in a situation where they can be criticized. Secondly, we have dependent. People who are dependent, as the name says, are very dependent. They can be very submissive. They can be very clingy. They may really need the help of others all the time. Now, I want to spend a second on obsessive-compulsive personality disorder because these people are very focused on their life being ordered, things being perfect, and for them to be in control of everything that's going on. And they do it to such an extent that it really annoys other people and it can delay projects at work and at school, because they're hyper-focused on these issues. So these are the 10 different personality disorders over these three different clusters. There is a large degree of controversy over this because not all the research has fully validated this concept. But this is the broad concept that we need to be aware of.